Hello guys, Gabba here. I'm making this video because I've seen a lot of new players and returning players, but what I've also seen is that they don't know what to do basically. They don't know what should be their goal, what should be their focus, and what which units should they play. So I'm making this video to help them out and enjoy the world of Conqueror's Blade. Let's get started. So first of all, at the very beginning of the game, what you should focus on is complete all the quests of the game that the games give you, because they will give you a lot of rewards, especially the F4 quest. If you press F4, you open this window, which there are a lot of challenges that you could complete, and they give you a lot of honor points and bronze, and also your XP. And later on also a lot of rewards that can help you out, like horses, let's see, skill points, unit attires, etc. that can be helpful. Also schematic, as you can see. So focus on this one. Also, as I said, focus on all the quests given, because also the main story and the weekly quest and the daily quest will give you a lot of rewards of honor point and bronze as well. So, what should be your overall goal? So, I will give you a lot of info, random informations that you have to put all together, okay? So, first of all, silver coins. You will earn them during the game, like opening secret vaults, etc. Try to keep them all, don't spend them at all, until you unlock... you have enough, which is 700k, to unlock this unit, Martellatori. Why Martellatori? Because Martellatori cost only 30 leadership, which is nothing in this game, and helps you a lot at the very beginning of the game, because when you play Martellatori or have your Rotti Mercenary unit, but Martellatori are the only one worth, Martellatori give, when you just put them in your warband, when you play Sieges and other modes, they give you bonuses. Which bonuses? They give you... as you can see, it's a bonus that gives you 10% hero XP, unit XP, and honor points in that battle, okay? So you have to fill them always, and since they cost leadership, so only 30 leadership, and they're really useful to push towers, because they give a buff to the towers, kinda, it's always good to have them. So it's a must unit to have, it's my favorite unit leadership-wise as well. So save your first 700k silver coins to buy Martellatori, nothing else, okay? Okay, so let's talk about gear. So your final goal of gear is to have a really good blue schematic gear set, which are these ones, Rogue, Carniflex and Guardsman, and a really good purple schematic weapon, okay? Like this one. The issue is... if you are a new player and you don't know which weapon is your choice, your life choice, just go to the Fame Store, which you can reach on going to the Fame Envoy, and it's only in every neutral city. Okay. Go to the Fame Store and you can purchase 3 sets of gear, light, medium and heavy armor, and just use them to train to see what's your game choice, like what's gonna be your main weapon, what's gonna be your main set. Because the issue is, as I said before, your goal is to have a blue schematic reforged gear, okay? The issue is that the game, even if you buy Battle Pass and you play a lot and you do all the donation, etc., doesn't give you enough resources to have 3 sets of gear with leadership and good stats. You can still do that, if you're very lucky, but if you try that, the issue will be that you will have 3 sets of gears that are very inferior of instead of having 1 set of gear that you focused on and you raised your stats and your leadership on them. So I suggest you to focus only on 1 kind of gear instead of 3. Okay, so use the Fame Store gear, train, try to use every weapon, try to find your best weapon, and then level up the set. Focus only on that set. Okay, don't focus on 3 sets. Instead, as a weapon, what you should focus on at the start of the game, I suggest you just use blue schematic weapons, because your final goal is to have a really good reforged purple schematic weapon. The issue is that the game doesn't give you enough purple schematics to have every weapon in the game, to try every weapon in the game with purple schematic and reforging them and having good stats, because sadly you don't get many purple schematics every season. You get like, if you have battle pass and if you do all your nation and you do all your rankets, you get like 4 or 5, nothing more. Then, so you cannot focus, and since you have to try multiple times to have actually good weapons and reforging it, you don't have enough resources to spend there. So what I suggest you to do is try the Fame Store gear, try blue schematic weapons, find your gear, find your weapon, and not only one, but just like try to find the weapons that you like but that can use only one gear. Example, I'll give you my personal example. I decided to play heavy armor, okay? As you can see, I play all heavy armor weapons. All heavy armor weapons. I don't play any other weapon, but I just focus on them. And I can focus only on one gear, and as you can see, I have all leadership on my gear and I reach 793 leadership. If I would have focused on multiple gears, I would probably have only blue reforged gears, 3 sets with low leadership, so that will affect my gameplay by a lot, not having all that leadership on one single set. Okay, so the units that you should focus on the season challenges are in order. Ignore season 2. Season 3, focus on Forte Braccios. You don't need his doctrine, so you actually need to complete 3 stages only, okay? Then, season 5, you need to focus on Star Wars. These ones. The Zikarians are also good, but for early game they're kinda hard to play. They're a really good unit, they're very competitive, but the issue is early game they're pretty hard to use. And even late game, if you don't have a team to cover them, they just get sniped by experienced players, because experienced players know the potential of Zikarians, so they will try to focus them, they will try to jump on them and kill them as fast as possible. So they're gonna be hard to play, but focus on Star Wars. And even on Star Wars, you don't need the doctrine. You don't need this doctrine, okay? So just focus, stop on stage 3. Then you go to season 7, okay? Season 7, you focus on Ferriers. Ferriers are a really good blue unit that can legit melt heroes like really fast when you press the number 2 skill. The doctrine, it's okay to have. It's not a must have, but it's a good doctrine to have on them. Focus there also on Shield Maidens. Shield Maidens is probably one of the best tier 5 infantry units at the moment. I like them a lot because they have an insane DPS, they melt heroes down like crazy, they're really fast. So you should focus on them as well. Meanwhile, you can farm also, since you're farming Maidens, you can farm Zerkers as well, since they're not saying they're really good against experienced players, but against kind of noobs that don't know what they do, they just melt units down like crazy, and they're really good on PvE mods, okay? Then after this, you can focus on the best unit in the game at the moment. It's this tier 4 unit, Mirmillons. Mirmillons are legit unstoppable right now, especially if you have the Stenfax Doctrine that gives them 2.5 seconds CC immunity. So if you use the Doctrine on their charge, basically their charge cannot be stopped and they just destroy everything, because they also deal blunt damage, and blunt defense is what most of units lack in the game. Okay, a lot of units don't have blunt defense, and since those guys deal an insane amount of blunt damage, they just destroy everything in the game. The issue though is that this unit is Doctrine dependent, kinda. You really need this Doctrine to make them really stronger. This Doctrine is a must-have, sadly, so you need to farm them until stage 4. And as a last unit, I suggest you to farm also our monks. New monks, these ones, are kinda insane. They just destroy everything with Tyrant Stopper at the moment. I hope they will nerf them, but they probably won't, so for now abuse them. Sadly though, you still need the Doctrine as well, so you need to farm them until stage 4. Okay? Unitary-wise, or with your honor, I suggest you, first of all, best unit leadership-wise in the game, in my opinion, cost-effective, are these guys. The blue Albedeers deal an insane amount of damage for their cost, and early game, for new players, I suggest you, like, if you don't have a lot of honor, just unlock them, just level them up. They're easy to level, easy to unlock, and they're just insane. A lot of damage, just what you wanna do is like, let me show you these guys. You go bottom veterancy on brace, you play around the brace, and use them mostly on F2 formation on the phalanx. They just auto brace kinda, and keep them there, keep them on choke points. Everything that goes inside them just dies. Besides, of course, Mirmillons, because Mirmillons and monks are broken, so those guys are just gonna melt them, but those are still a blue unit. They just cost 175 leadership. It's nothing. One thing, don't use the charge. They just die with the charge, so avoid this. Another issue, though, is that you need the stun on brace doctrine, which they're kinda dependent, because they don't have a stun on brace by default, like their purple counterpart, okay? As honor unit 3, you should focus also on Imperial Pikes, because Imperial Pikes, they recently got kinda buffed, now they knock back also shielded units, but they are a really good counter for cavalry, monks, and monks, and what's that? And a good counter to Forte Braccio as well. Plus, if you have like a friend with cavalry, you can advance them into like enemy formation, and while you're advancing, your friend with cavalry can swipe through them and wipe the entire enemy team, okay? Not the unit that you should focus with unit 3 are stalwarts, sorry, spear sergeants. Because if you're focusing on Season 5 Stalwarts, Stalwarts are the direct upgrade version of Spear Sergeants, so you need Spear Sergeant in order to have Stalwarts. So if you focus on Stalwarts, which is probably one of the best shield units in the game, because they're really tanky and they deal a lot of damage as well when you brace them, you need to have Spear Sergeant first. And then another unit that you should focus are Winged Hussars, because it's the best cavalry unit in the game, in my opinion. Cost effective, enter very easy to use, and they just, if there are no braced pikes, they just destroy everything in their path. Another good unit to have are Daggerax Lancers. I made a lot of video about them. The issue is that if you're not really confident, don't use them, because if you don't really know what you're doing, where you're going, what you're facing, they're just gonna die, you're gonna use the unit. So don't use, at the start of the game, don't use a lot of cavalry units, because their kits are really expensive, because when you repair kinda cavalry units, you have to repair the unit kit itself and also the horse, so it's gonna be really expensive at the start of the game for new players, okay? Okay, so your daily focus in the game should be complete all the daily quests that the Sheris gives you, because they give you honor, bronze, and also the first victory of the day gives you 2 green wisdoms. Second is, as your daily focus should be, this sadly it's a PvE mod, it's deploying defend, you need to complete it 2 times a day, because every time you complete it, this mod gives you 2 green wisdoms and 1 box. for a total of 2 box and 4 wisdom, so 2 times a day only. On the box you will get mostly just green wisdoms. If you get those, it's better, but you will never get them, probably. I mean, I don't, you will get them for sure. And so you will get, with that mod, a total of 6 green wisdoms. And with the first victory of the day, you get 2 green wisdoms, which is a total of 8, which is a try in the Doctrinal Alchemy system. And that's sadly the only daily way to try to catch up with experienced player or older players on the Doctrine system. Instead, your weekly goal should be to complete your weekly quests, which are these ones with on the L menu, because these quests give you a lot of resources, a lot of bronze, a lot of honor, and a lot of wisdoms and treaties. As you can see, they give you a lot of this. Sorry. And also you need to complete F5 weekly quest, because they help you a lot with completing the battle pass. Okay, they give you a lot of glory to complete the battle pass. Okay, but don't worry, those weeklies are not really hard. Just by playing the game you will complete them. The only issue with this weekly quest is that you have to also play a little bit of free battle, death matches, and bandit raids. Speaking about bandit raids, that's also a weekly goal that you have to complete, let's say, because there are 5 bandit raids that give you rewards every week. Rewards are a lot of XP and a lot of fame. Okay. Also, use the hero and unit cards like these ones just on bandit raids. Don't use them on sieges, because sieges don't give you enough experience to be worth using hero and unit cards. Just use them on bandit raids, okay? Also, bandit raids give you fame, as I said, and you need fame to complete to buy very useful stuff on the fame store, okay? Especially artificer stones and purple schematics and treatises, okay? And the doctrine as well. Another weekly goal is that now, when you play sieges, every week you can earn up to 1500 fame points, okay? You get 100 points every win and 60 every lose, okay? Up to 1.5k every week. This is another weekly goal that you have to achieve in order to complete and buy very useful stuff with the fame store. Another weekly thing that you have to do is complete your donations. Complete your donations in order to get Artificer Stones, blue, and if you are really lucky, also purple schematics. I will say this, in 5 weeks of donations at the moment, completing them all, I didn't get any purple schematic yet. Okay? So, good luck with that. But you need to complete those donations to get fame points, to get materials that can be very helpful. Another thing that you have to do weekly, if you don't have problem with bronzes, just buy everything on the apothecary store. It's not really worth it. It's not really worth it, because if you have problems with bronze and you need materials, the best way to do so is to buy saddles. This one, riveted saddles, from the horse seller, and smelt them to the smith. You just salvage them to the smith, and you will get more materials bronze wise respect to buying them on the apothecary. The issue is this process takes a lot of time and it's fucking boring. And it's fucking, I don't know what they're doing with the game about this kind of mechanic, but doing this is way more worth bronze-wise than buy stuff from the apothecary, but takes a lot of time. I just do it time to time when like I'm queue for sieges or when I'm like defending in territory war and no one is attacking. Okay. Also, don't play ranged units unless they are Shenjis, Zikalians, Sivos and Falconetti, because even though at the start of the game you were feeling very confident with them, they show it's you were probably fighting bots or new players as well. Later in the game, all their experience and good players will just farm them, like with traps or just with heroes, because also they bring zero support to your teammates, okay? So just avoid playing ranged also because you will not improve your gameplay at all with playing them. Maybe the only ranged worth to use at the moment besides the special units that I said before are incendiary archers, but that's only on a competitive level gameplay like high level ranked or tournaments, simply because a really meta unit in tournament are camels, and camels really suffer to fire damage, and fire archers are the most ranged the fire unit with most range in the game. So besides that, the rest are kind of worthless in my opinion. Another thing that I would like to suggest is try to play ranked as soon as possible, because your seasonal goal is to reach Grand Champion, because ranked give you a lot of rewards, as you can see. They give you both rewards when you reach that rank, and they will give you rewards based on at the end of the season based on the rank that you reached. Another thing that you should do, especially as a new player, find a house. Like press N and look for an house to join, because houses can give you first of all, you can join territory wars, which you can do to complete some weeklies, some campaigns, some challenges, etc. Plus in some houses there are stipends, so you can save up some bronzes using house funds in order to pay your unit kits, so you will save some bronzes for yourself. Issue is though is that cohorts don't give you any kind of bronze, so don't join cohorts, join an actual house. Plus some houses, if you're not active in territory wars, they will not give you any stipend, so try to find a house based on your necessities, okay? One more thing that I got asked is if it's worth to buy premium and battle pass. They are good to have because battle pass is this and premium is gives you this bonus. The fuck is it now? A lot. But they're most likely premium is most likely a pay to skip kind of mechanic. It's not a must have. I basically played the whole game without premium for most of it. I used it at the start because I was like I wanted to play competitive at the start, so I bought premium account. But if you manage your bronze properly, you don't need it. You don't really need it. It's just a pay to skip mechanic. Battle Pass instead gives you a lot of resources, really too, like, not that many, but a lot that can help you out. And also it gives you horse, hero and unit attire. So if you don't care about attires, I mean, it's up to you. Honestly, it's all up to you. I usually buy it because I think it's worth it, and still I want to give something back to the game since it's a free to play, but it's not a must have to play this game, okay? So it's all up to you. Thank you guys for watching, I hope this video can be helpful to someone, and if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments and I will for sure reply to them, okay? So see you in Siege, bye!